do enjoy today's performance, but as Eric mentioned, musicians are now really support more these days, and this is an opportunity for us to support them and give them a token of our appreciation for sharing their artistry with us. So thanks in advance for your goodwill and generosity. Great. So we're going to start moving our way to the live streams webpage. I do notice that we have gotten a lot more creative with Zoom, but there are a few minor details that will all help us all to have the best audio and video experiences possible. If you look at the bottom left-hand corner of your screen, you should see an icon that looks like a microphone. That is the icon that you can use to mute or unmute yourself. We ask that you keep yourself muted for the duration of the performance so that it minimizes audio interference and we can have the best listening experience possible. Next to that, you should see another icon to the bottom of your screen that looks like a video camera video recorder. It says stop video. That icon is the icon you can use, or button you can use to turn your video on or off. You're welcome to keep your video on throughout the performance to the extent you're comfortable. However, we do note that if you are joining
via
cell phone,
turn it down,
a tablet, an iPhone, an iPad, any mobile device, we ask that you leave the Zoom room for the duration of the performance. Once it's over, please come back and join us here in the Zoom room for a question and answer time with the musicians. We make this request because we have learned that if you try to run your Zoom app and your video streaming app on your mobile device at the same time, it will overwhelm the device and lead to audio and video errors. And we want you to have the best experience as possible. So if you are joining the mobile device, we ask that you mute the Zoom room and then come back and join us once the performance is over. Okay. Now I'm going to go ahead and include the link to the live stream in the chat.
Right here, you
can
see two. Still see it. Here? Yes. Fine.
All right. You should see this link populate in the chat feature here in Zoom. If you click on that link, it should take you immediately or directly to the live stream's webpage. At the top of the page, you see the title of today's performance, today's program. You should then underneath that see a green button that says Join Pre-Concert Zoom here. You don't need to click that button because that's where we are right now. And underneath that, you should see an embedded window that hosts the live stream's video feed. And you should also see a YouTube chat stream where you're welcome to provide your praises, your comments, your fun emojis. So that is where we will be gathering to enjoy today's live stream. Another note, it's not a requirement, but we do recommend enjoying the performance with earbuds or headphones or earphones to have the most enhanced audio experience. But if you don't, by no means is that a deal breaker. You should still have a very enjoyable experience. Lastly, if you run into some technical difficulties, you can message me here directly in Zoom and I will do my best to assist you. All you need to do is click the chat feature and in the Zoom portion, it has a little tab and it says everyone, but if you click on that tab, you should find my name and you can send me a direct message if you run into some technical difficulties. Okay. Now, I need your help for this part. If you could let me know by providing a thumbs up in the screen or a thumbs up emoji or ready in the chat that you have been able to access the link, access the webpage, and you can see the live stream for that video, that would be helpful for me so I can let our musicians know that they can go ahead and start. Thanks, Theo. Felicia?
Just gonna text you, right?
Yeah.
Just gonna text you, right?
Yeah.
Right.
the message.
I
Thank you very much. I can almost hear the clapping. Welcome to our concert, which I like to call A Parisian in the Americas, a play on an American in Paris, of course. The first piece we played was written by George Gershwin, who also wrote An American in Paris. And it was just a little arrangement I did so that Juan could read the music and I could improvise. We won't be playing any more jazz for you today, but the rest of this is classical music. And that I've Got Rhythm was included in, I forget the year now, but it was in the Broadway musical called Girl Crazy. Of course, and I made a little introduction there of Rhapsody in Blue, the famous George Gershwin piano concerto. The next piece we'd like to play for you, I'm going to let Juan talk about because he's a Brazilian composer and a friend of his.
Good evening, everybody. Thank you all for being on our live stream concert. We're going to play now Ernest Mali's Sonatina 1974. Ernest Mali was born in Germany in 1929 and moved to Brazil in 1951. He is now recognized as more Brazilian than a lot of other Brazilian composers. He founded the School of Music in my hometown, Piracicaba. It's one of the most important music schools in the country. And he devoted a lot of himself writing for kids and writing for all the instruments. He kind of learned all the instruments and wrote to all the instruments because when he moved to Brazil, there was not published works for the instruments. He wanted to put an orchestra together in there. He was a really generous man that offered lots of scholarships to students. We're really pleased to play the Sonatina 1974, which is a work that he wrote for students. And you can see a lot of Brazilian influences in here, the rhythms. And he loves the modal modalism. And also, he used the sonata form in most of his sonatinas and concertinas. I hope you enjoy. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. That was Ernst Mahle, Sonatina, 1974. And now we'd like to move on to the sonata. Sonatina, of course, means a small sonata. Here's a full sonata with three movements by Francis Poulenc. Poulenc was a Parisian composer and a member of what we know as Les Six, or the Six. This phrase was coined by a music critic, and it included six composers from Paris. See if I can remember them all. Georges Auric, Louis Duret, Germain Taillefer, Arthur Honegger, Darius Milhaud, and Francis Poulenc. Benny Goodman commissioned this work by Francis Poulenc, and he was going to premiere it with Francis Poulenc playing piano, 1952, I believe, but Poulenc died that year, and so Leonard Bernstein and Benny Goodman premiered it at Carnegie Hall the following year, 1953. What they were writing was kind of a reaction to impressionism in classical music. Composers like Debussy, Ravel, those kind of composers, they were writing in a different style, a newer style, a more modern style. Anyhow, I hope you enjoy this sonata. This is actually probably my favorite sonata ever written for the clarinet and piano. It was taught to me by my grandfather. It was also his favorite sonata for the clarinet. And my grandfather, of course, Loris Wiles, he's the father of one of our audience members, Ann Wiles, which is my mom. So here we are, Francis Poulenc's sonata for clarinet and piano.
Thank you.
Poulenc Sonata. We're going to take a very short 5-minute break for intermission, and we'll be right back. Please don't turn off your device. Just wait for us with our little screen. Thank you. See you soon. Sorry about the technical difficulties. I think we have it sorted out, hopefully. We're going to proceed with the second half of the concert, and then if there's time at the end, we'll repeat the first half of the concert for you. I understand that it will be available after the fact. Anyhow, here is Luz by Villani Cortez.
Yeah, this piece is written by Edmundo Villani Cortez, Brazilian composer. He wrote this for his son, Lucas, that died. And Luz means light in English. It's a beautiful piece that was written originally for the piano, and he arranged it for the clarinet and piano. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
That was loose. Leslie, would you let me know if that broadcast? Hopefully it did, and the next piece we'd like to play for you is called Piece en Forme de Habanera. And the habanera, of course, is the most famous and important dance rhythm from Cuba, from South America, of all of the different dance rhythms. And perhaps the most famous one was written by Georges Bizet in his opera Carmen. And this one is by Maurice Ravel. The Europeans picked up these dance forms, and they actually did more with them musically in some cases than some of the Latin American composers did. So I see that we are broadcasting, so that's great. Thank you. So this one is Pièce en Forme de Habanera, Maurice Ravel. We decided to skip the one, sorry, Eric, that I wrote, and we'll probably play it on the next concert, which hopefully will include all music written for us.
The next portion of the program, we will be playing for you four songs that are originally for voice and piano by Heitor Villa-Lobos. Heitor Villa-Lobos is, with no doubt, the most prolific composer in the whole South America. In fact, his piece, Baquianas Brasileiras No. 5, The Aria, is one of the most popular pieces in the whole world. You probably heard it at some point. Villa-Lobos is a really interesting character. He had really few training, studied just a little bit of harmony, but he mostly learned music from observing his father, that was a popular musician. He played the clarinet, he played the cello, and he played the guitar. And he was married with a really famous and good pianist. He made his living playing on cinema, and also on silent movies, and also playing on theater and circus. Villa-Lobos is a really interesting character. Travel all over Brazil and collect a lot of the folk materials from all over the country. I strongly recommend you guys to watch some of his movie. It's available on YouTube. It's kind of funny, the movie, because the actors are also popular Brazilian actors, so they can't really play the instrument. But it's a good movie that represents really well his life. These pieces that we're playing, we're starting with Modinha. Then we are doing Villa-Lobos, Saudades da Minha Vida. It means missing of my life. And then we're doing Canção do Amor, it's the love song. And then the last one is really well known, Melodia Sentimental, Sentimental Melody. And I'm particularly grateful for Ben to learn and transcribe them for the clarinet, since they're originally written for voice. But I think Ben does a wonderful job on playing the words on the clarinet. I hope you enjoy on this. We hope to probably record some of these songs. They're such beautiful music. I hope you enjoy the four Villa-Lobos songs.
I try to play these with a Brazilian accent.
Thank you. Thank you.
And we'd like to end the second half with what we would usually reserve for an encore, but instead we'll play it as a part of this program. This is Oblivion by Astor Piazzolla. Of course, Piazzolla was an Argentinian composer. He studied with the famous teacher Nadia Boulanger, and he became famous when he started incorporating his Argentinian tango into his classical music writing. Thank you very much. It dawned on me that people probably have time constraints today, so maybe we should go straight to the Zoom question and answer session, and then we can discuss what happened and what we can do to correct this next time. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for watching. I just want to, before ending, give a big thank to the First Christian Church in Baton Rouge for the live streaming here. We have Pastor David Chisholm here, Reverend helping, and we have Ted Baldwin too. So I want to, we appreciate your help, and thank you very much for being here, and thank you all. So we will switch to our Zoom meeting now. Thank you all.